Hi, my name is Dr. Pelayo Salinas de Leon, and I'm the head of fisheries and sharks research for the Charles Darwin Foundation. I'm the principal investigator for the Galapagos Spawning Aggregation Project,
financed by the Disney Worldwide Conservation Fund and Fundación Ataman. I supervise a team of three different staff members,
including project scientist David Acuña, undergraduate thesis student Daniela Vilema, and international project volunteer Etienne Rastoin. So the aim of this project is to characterize the first ever recorded spawning aggregation for the Galapagos endemic grouper and for two snapper species in the Galapagos Marine Reserve and the occurrence of whale sharks within these aggregations. So the project has three different components. One is the characterization of the spawning aggregations. The second one is an educational component to raise environmental awareness. Other team member, Daniela Vilema, is in charge of the educational campaign, and she's working with a number of local schools and different stakeholders. And the final one is to use all the information gathered to work together with the Galapagos National Park Directorate to promote the conservation measures. This project is really important because in other parts of the world, a lot of the populations have been depleted because of overfishing during aggregation events. Under the current Galapagos Marine Reserve zoning scheme, most of these aggregation sites are open to fishing. So the ultimate goal is to avoid the overfishing of these unique events. We conducted two campaigns in October and November, and we successfully documented the spawning aggregating behavior for the Galapagos grouper and also for the two snapper species. We also identified a new aggregation site for the endemic grouper and a different location at Wolf Island, and also documented the occurrence of whale shark in these aggregations. So we started a database for the photo identification of whale sharks, which over the next year is going to allow us to infer the importance of these events for the whale sharks. So the next steps are going to be focused on continuing the educational campaign. We have 4 intensive months ahead of us, visiting all Galapagos schools and talking to the next generation of Galapagos citizens and conservationists. These are the kids between 7 and 9 years old, in which we'll be sharing all the findings of our project and showing them all the amazing footage and video we've been collecting. With additional funding, we'll be able to continue the monitoring of these spawning aggregation sites for the Galapagos grouper. Also, we will aim to continue the educational campaign with the idea of producing a booklet about the spawning aggregations. And we will continue to use the data gathered by this project to promote the protection of spawning aggregation sites within the Galapagos Marine Reserve. It's been a great project. I guess one of the highlights has been taking Mickey diving with the hammerhead sharks, Galapagos endemic groupers, and whale sharks. We're very excited with the idea of starting the second phase of this project, and hopefully we'll be able to continue this project in the long term, giving it importance.